Hey all, this is Sammy from Avid CNC. This is a walkthrough on how to calibrate and make adjustments after you've installed your Avid CNC rotary axis. Please refer to the Avid CNC rotary instructions also linked below. You can navigate to it through our website. These step-by-step instructions will be critical to follow in addition to this video. We will reference several steps, screenshots, and reference images from these instructions. The calibration procedure will need to be completed each time the rotary assembly is installed on the CNC machine. If you have not previously installed and configured Mach 4 for your CNC machine, please complete the CNC software setup guide prior to calibrating your rotary. This rotary calibration procedure will vary based on how you've chosen to orient your rotary axis in relation to your CNC machine frame. The alignment procedure will assist in both leveling and squaring the rotary frame in relation to your machine. First, in Mach 4, under the Machine Setup tab, select Spindle with Rotary Axis Enabled. Then click Enable. And then home the X, Y, and Z axes, allowing the machine to reset its machine coordinates. The calibration procedure will need to be completed each time the rotary axis is installed on the CNC machine. Remove the current collet you have installed and replace it with the supplied 8mm ER20 collet. Then insert the M8 dowel pin. Be sure to insert the beveled end into the spindle. We will position the tailstock at the end of the rotary frame. Then lock the tailstock in place using the spring plungers. Place your Auto Z touch plate on the touch plate isolator. Note how the corner wall lines up to the isolator. It should fit in snugly. We will drive the spindle over and position the bottom of the dowel pin roughly 25 millimeters or about 1 inch above the center of the touch plate. Ensure that the magnet on the touch plate is attached to the dowel pin in the spindle. Click the Auto Z touch plate button. Now that we've enabled rotary cutting in Mach 4, there will be a rotary tab with rotary specific touch off and calibration functions. Enter the tool diameter of 8 and select millimeters for units. In the rotary calibration section, we will select the mounting type and orientation of your rotary assembly. The diagram buttons illustrate the orientation for each mounting orientation option. Please note that the images and instructions shown in Mach 4 will differ depending on your mounting type, mounting orientation, and rotary frame length. Then click the Frame Alignment button. We'll follow the instructions shown in Mach 4 for the rotary frame alignment. Step 1, to probe the first position. Once we've probed the first position, we'll slide the tailstock to the chuck end and lock it in place. We'll position the spindle above the touch plate and attach the magnet. Then click the Start Probing button again. You will now see two values on the screen. First, the adjustment distance. This is the amount to adjust the end of the rotary frame shown by the blue arrow in the image. This will square the rotary frame to the gantry, as well as raise chuck or tailstock end. This is the amount to adjust the jack screws on the designated end of your rotary frame. This will level the rotary frame in relation to your machine table. Just a reminder, the direction you'll need to adjust and the bolts you'll need to loosen on your rotary will be different depending on the axis that you've mounted your rotary parallel to. At the three indicated corners, loosen the fasteners attaching the undermount plates to the machine cross members. Do not loosen the fasteners on the fourth unmarked corner. This will serve as your pivot. Adjust the frame in the direction and the amount that was shown on the screen in Mach 4. Use calipers to make the micro adjustments, then tighten the fasteners at the three indicated corners. Now we'll also raise or lower the tailstock or chuck end. Loosen the indicated fasteners attached to the undermounting plates to the rotary frame. Loosen the jack screw nuts, and then tighten the jack screws to raise the rotary frame. A quarter turn of the jack screws will raise the frame approximately 0.3 millimeters or 12 thousandths of an inch. Be sure to raise the right and left jack screws the exact same amount when leveling your rotary. Then tighten the fasteners and jam nuts at the indicated locations. Yeah. Now we will repeat the frame alignment to ensure that our adjustments are within tolerance. It is recommended to repeat this step until you have the adjustment distances within 5/1000ths of an inch. Next, we can set the mid supports. Let's slide the tailstock just above the mid supports. We'll follow the instructions shown in Mach 4 for the rotary frame alignment, step 4, to probe the mid support locations. You will now see an amount to adjust the mid support jack screws. The procedure is the same for adjusting the height of the chuck or tail end. Loosen the fasteners attaching the mid support plates to the rotary frame. Loosen the jack screw jam nuts. Tighten the jack screws to raise the center of the rotary frame. Then tighten the fasteners and jam nuts at the indicated locations. Then repeat the set mid supports on your mock pop-up until you have the height within 5/1000ths. You may need to repeat the mid support procedure more than once to achieve proper alignment. Now onto the touch plate offset. Before continuing, it is highly recommended to read the full section of the touch plate offset instructions to be familiar with the probing routines used. Improper placement of the spindle may cause the machine to crash. Also, do not forget to attach the magnets in the correct placement. We also recommend having the e-stop in hand if this is your first time running the rotary calibration. We'll remove the tailstock live center and position the tailstock closer to the chuck. Insert the chuck locating pin into the chuck with the flange of the bushing flush against the chuck jaws and then tightening the chuck. First, we'll drive the spindle over to the touch plate and set the touch plate location. Ensure that the magnet from the touch plate is attached to the dowel pin in the spindle. Do not do anything with the magnet attached to the chuck locating pin just yet. We'll click the Set Touch Plate Offset button. Click Start Probing. Once that operation is complete, we'll position the spindle over the chuck locating pin as indicated. Ensure that there will be ample clearance between the collet nut and the chuck jaws. We'll connect the magnet from the touch plate to the dowel pin in the spindle, and then connect the magnet from the chuck locating pin to the touch plate. Once you verify that the spindle, chuck locating pin, and magnets are all in the correct locations, click Start Probing. The probing routine will probe the top of the chuck locating pin, followed by each side. The touch plate can now be used to offset your cutting tool to the center of your chuck. This is analogous to setting the Z offset to the machine bed for flat or non-rotary programs. Thanks everyone for watching. Stay tuned for more rotary project and pro tip videos soon. See y'all in the shop.